Hello, all you lovely beans out there, and welcome back to another episode of What is the Fox Play with Phoenix Firestar. Yeah, see, there's Jasmine right there. I am going to be 1 second. I'm going to go tuck my son in to bed. So I'll be right back. And then I'll continue on to the Elite Four and hopefully beat him tonight. Meep. Alright, I am back. Let's continue on to the Elite Four. What are the environment people and Pokemon are adapt to live there? That's what we all do to survive. My name is Jasmine, and I'm a gym leader. Well, I'm sorry, not the gym leader of this city. I'm a gym leader in the Johto region. It'd be nice if you knew about the Johto region. Oh, that's this city's gym badge. You must be very good. Please take this too. Each of those technical machines contains a waterfall. If you use waterfall from the Pokédex, you'll be able to get to the Pokémon League. I'm very far away because I wanted to get stronger. On the way, I met all sorts of people with their Pokémon. They all looked like they were having fun. I felt happy seeing it. And a journey across the waves. Away! I'm sure they will eventually. It may be a few years before we see another remake, though. I mean, I know Game Freak's usually really good at pushing the, capabilities of the DS, but they are so stuck on having used the DS, they're kind of almost not sure what to do with these consoles, like the big consoles. I am determined to go to the Pokemon League no matter how hard it is. No, I don't think there's going to be any more evolutions unless they add in a new typing. Because if you go back and look at it, all the evolutions were Pokemon that had, that used, whose typing were a special, used a special attack stat in Generation 1. Losing won't make me give up. The Pokemon League isn't going anywhere. Excuse me for wearing my bikini. Like, as if you look at it, fire, electric, water all use special attack stat in Generation 1. They all have evolutions. Then it was Umbreon and Espeon, who both use special attack stat in Generation 1 and 2. Then there was Grass and Ice, which both use special attack stat in Generation 1. And then they just added Eeveelutions. Or Sylveon. But that was a new typing that didn't exist previously. And while there are other types that they couldn't make Eeveelutions out of, I think they've just about used all the ones that use the special type attack stat. That was Meryl. The ultimate quick attack. Although one thing interesting that happened is Cartoon Network brought back King of the Hill. I just kind of enjoyed the dry wit of it. Or the dry humor, I guess. Not dry wit, just dry humor. The name is Shackleford. Rusty Shackleford. Of course the government's listening in on me. And you don't even want to know what the cockroaches are saying. Pocket sand. Ha cha cha. A little bit of slightly hidden land there. Yeah, I remember that there was one. I had no problem with the trees in Sword and Shield. I train at a Pokemon gym too. Don't think they're going to win easy. Give who a Garbodor and a Caterpie? Master Wake! No, Crusher Wake, I'm so sorry to have failed you. Hey, I beat him too. What to do, train at the gym again or train by myself? I don't know, I think your Pokemon are higher level than his already. Don't have enough attacks on that Bronzong. Makes it difficult to get much done. All these Tentacruel. Bronzong cannot escape from anything. Runaway has to do with your Pokemon's speed, though, so it makes sense. Man, encounter rates in the water are high. And they're all Tentacruel. I don't know. I think they kind of, yeah, I heard that Rhydon's design was like one of the first ones that was written or drawn out. But, I think Nintendo kind of just ran with the whole joke idea that, like, the, B-Barrel Bidoof line were HM slaves in this generation because they could learn, like, all of them. All the HMs, just about. My dream was to swim in the sea in every region under the sun. Deep breathing before battle. Yep, pink or blue. I mean, I remember they had like one Meryl who was a bit of a crybaby. No, Pikachu can't learn any move. Only a handful of Pokemon can learn every move, and that's like Mew, Smeargle. And I think that's about it. Well, it's only, like, rare Pikachu that can use Fly and Surf. And the flying Pikachu is just a Pikachu with a bunch of balloons tied to it. So, I mean, I've never seen a Pikachu use teleport. Inhale, exhale. Yeah, I remember Pikachu used to be bigger. He's slimmed down a bit over the last couple of years. Doomsday. I found a trainer who's floating in the water. I'm not exactly floating, I'm riding on something. Oh, yeah, him. Yeah, he was not too bright. Yeah, you got quite a few people killed and stuff. Yes, it is. Jeez, yeah, it's been a while since I've actually sat down and listened to any commentary for a movie. Used to do that all the time. Mainly with comedies, but. I mean, they destroyed a lot of stuff in that movie. I came out here because I wanted to see the Pokemon League for myself. Several warehouses. Bus, a doghouse. So many fences. I didn't know his name. And so he tried to pull a push door and got himself eaten. Oh, there was also the entire dock. Yeah, I remember Jaws. I think they are just about like that in every movie media outlet, though. I mean, they're definitely unequipped to handle a dinosaur, but I mean, who is? That's like one of those things where you have to specifically be, equipped to handle that kind of situation. That's not a situation you can just handle at any point of time. I mean, not all of it, only like parts of it. I mean, that's why the T-Rex destroyed it, was the gas prices. Plus, turning his friends into fossil fuels wasn't exactly a good maneuver either. The tide is going out. Oh, jeez, I forget how far it is up here to. Yeah, probably not. The Three Road, it lives up to that lofty name. It broke me once, but that only added to my resolve. So everyone here is pretty much adequately leveled for the Elite Four. Bronzong is not. That's the real reason why they're like, could you just remove the gas prices? No, those gotta stay in. Then you can't use our gas station. I mean, Pokemon was out before the "Don't go into the tall grass." Even here in America, it was out before then. The only Pokemon that senses the subtle flows of seawater using its two antennae. That doesn't seem right. Ah. Yeah, that's weird, because I could have sworn I was playing Pokemon before that came out. Yes, I know I can surf, but I'd rather swim instead. It does seem weird, I agree. Now, it seems weird that I'm required to have a Pokemon to surf to move across water, even small amounts of it. Yeah, it felt like I was playing Pokemon well before that movie came out. But I guess Jurassic World did come out a year before Pokemon in America. It's weird, because Kaploosh, why'd you snap your own goggles? I mean, the Pokemon franchise was definitely already over here by then. Like, I'm pretty sure the show was out here, but it's just my memory. I thought I was playing Pokemon before that came out. Huh. Pokemon was out in 1987. Or 1997. Here, a year before the games came out. And the first episode was aired on April 1st. Surprisingly enough. Yeah, what happened to poor Porygon? Technically, it was Pikachu's fault, but they couldn't blame the mascot. And it definitely, definitely wasn't any of the CEO's fault or anyone else in charge. It's also the reason why Porygon has not been in an episode of Pokemon since. So now I've beaten everyone between here and there. I remember I caught a shiny one of you back in Generation 3. I was mad because, like, of all the Pokemon, I get you. Because I was not a big fan of Pelipper. It was like making, just because Gyarados worked as a water flying type doesn't mean other Pokemon will work as a flying water type. In fact, I'm pretty sure you only made Gyarados a water flying type was to help give it a weakness. A more clear cut weakness than just one electric weak, one point of weakness to electricity. We don't have to, but there is a thing to come back and do later here. Towards the end, I think, where you get to team up with someone and they have like an Arcanine. Be warned, mortal. I can see the future. I can see the future! Dang it. Hi, Gypsy. That was a lot of damage from that curse. It's like they how they decided Gengar was too overpowered, so took away his levitate ability. So be it. I will not I will not divulge what I know of your future. In the Pokemon League ahead, the Elite Four await you. But you knew that already. I mean, everyone knows that. That doesn't necessarily mean you're psychic. Yeah, I mean, like, the game came first in the anime in Japan. And they already knew that they were going to make a second one by the time the anime came out. Hello, PokéNoob. Oh, you know, just chugging along here, trying to get to the Elite Four. I mean, I guess, but I don't know if they'd exactly understand the concept of it. Because sometimes dogs will pick up on what they're... humans feel. I don't know if they're exactly being, Yeah, it's fine. How's your day been today, PokéNoob? I, Gypsy. Yeah, it's a kitty cat. If it was a dog, they wouldn't be in. They wouldn't be trying to be in, stand in the way. Isn't that right? No. Wings of Freedom. I know I'll find them if I can win my way through the Pokemon League. I mean, yeah, everyone would have to at some point. If you could chill it on that kind of talk, please. It's all right, just, you know, I don't fashion this as a kid's channel, but there's still just, you know, certain things that you shouldn't be saying like that in a public stream. Show me how you've battled to get here. Let's do this. Oops, sneezed the cat away. Sorry, Gypsy. So that's how you battled. Once you emerge from Victory Road, the Pokemon League lies directly ahead. Many trainers fail to ever find their way on Victory Road. Smash! You. One look at you tells me you're a real contender. Eat him. Eat him hard. Maybe we'll run to the other side of the road when I walk by him. It's a golem item. What? Doesn't sound like a very good goal. So I can't just go back that way. Oh, come on. Jeez, all these crowbat and everything. Crobats. Gypsy Rose. Oh, careful. The Total Stranger would be a good way to see if I have what it takes to own the Pokemon League's Elite Four. That'd be the better option right there. Oh, darn fairy types. Oh, I suppose I could use Lucario's Meteor Mash. Wild Pokemon here are only a distraction. Only battle the trainers. That battle just now must make you tougher than everyone in the world. as it appears if anyone could even try to stand against your might, the Elite Four should just surrender. Maybe you just held yourself in a little too high self-esteem there. Let me take a measure of how much you have raised your Pokemon. If I gave Bronzong Psychic instead of Future Sight, that would be better. Come here, baby. Gypsy. Brilliant. Rather than navigating Victory Road, I have a much better time putting young trainers like you to the test. No, I didn't want to go down. I want to go up. They could have just said, you know, the trainer's able to do that. I think I already messed up. I did. I don't want to go down. Quit making me go down. I need to perfect my double battle technique. That'll make me better all around. I want to improve my technique as a trainer, and I can, as a double battler, as much as I can. Muddy waters. Only hit Garchomp there. Not gonna get anywhere that way. All these earthquakes down here lately. My goodness, you are great at double battles. You're an expert double battler too? I don't have the psychic TM to give out yet either. Well, come on, I just want to get out of here. My Pokemon have been fighting long and hard enough. Give them a break. Okay, almost back over here. Push your attack and your defense. Oof. My Pokemon knows karate. I'm warning you, it's a tough one. You knocked off my soft sand. That would have finished you off. I've met my match in strength. I can see the past. There's just so much in your past. Did you meet a legendary Pokemon? No, that can't be right. Dragon Pulse. Making an already strong Pokemon grow even stronger. I'll need your help with this. Was that your strong Pokemon? Let me show you a real strong Pokemon. Okay, why you're using a Dragon type attack on a Steel type, I don't know, but moving on. There's no way I could have won. How am I gonna teach it the most powerful dragon type moves? Well, you must pin my defeat, huh? Meet your mash. That wasn't how I planned the final chapter to go in my writing class. We miss them. So it's you guys out here. You and your Pokemon make a beautiful combination. You and your Pokemon will gain power by helping each other out. I'm trying to get there. There's nothing else up this way. Forgot how confusing this place is to navigate. I saw my whole team was ready for the Elite Four. Chroma. I'm pretty sure the exit is here somewhere. Not exit, but to get to the next area, you have to be back in here somewhere. Did I miss it when I wasn't looking? During one of my lapses of not paying full attention to what was going on around me? Probably up there, I just missed it, didn't I? Yep, there it is. Well, looks like I might be out of Moo Moo Milk. Like I said, that your Pokemon have a lot of trust in you. your Pokemon. You seem to be aglow. Ronzong, I could see the future. No, I don't want to learn Rain Dance, or at least I don't want Rain Dance on that Pokemon. Close combat. Empoleon! I understand now. You blaze with so much vitality. Actually, I think this is the side path, because that takes you up to the place where you're like, oh, you can't get through here till you beat the Elite Four. Like, nope. Dark Pulse. Oof. Eat their soul, Mulan. Yeah, see, that's the person. Top level trainers gather around this place naturally. I'd go so far as to call it the ideal place to train with the best. Alright, since that's about the only dragon type they have here, it's probably the entire Gible line this guy has. Eat the Gible soul. And then we'll just Aura Sphere the rest of it. Oh, it's another Gible. A Gyarados, really? Break free. Completely subverted my expectations. Congratulations. But you still lost. That's why I like you here. I get to battle tough characters like you. When two roads diverge, you must choose the path less traveled. Well, I don't have to fight Barry before I get out there and heal. I'll be fine. Ooh. I finally made it. Woo, I'm here. I can get my luxury balls here. Good. Let's get 35. I'll need that many, but eh. Pokemon are so calm, even though they're up against the Elite Four. I like how they're so loose and relaxed. Hold it! Don't go off without me! You're challenging the Pokemon League, aren't you? That's why I'm here, too. So you're more worthy of making the challenge with a battle. Excellent. One more Brian will kill me, so nope. Fair enough. Is that your best hope? Garchomp fell asleep. Yeah, sure, he's asleep, so I'll switch. I fully believe that this last one, I have no reason to freak out. What just went down? My team still needs raising? Guess I'm not ready for the Pokemon League if I couldn't beat you. Just you wait. I'll get tougher and win my way through to the Pokemon League. Because I'm going to become the toughest Pokemon trainer there is. The champion. Phoenix, you better not lose to anyone before me. Make it from that you're qualified to challenge the Pokemon League. To do so, I'll need to examine the gym badges you gathered from around Sinnoh. Thank you all you lovely beings for tuning in out there, and I'll see you all in the next episode of What is the Fox Play with Phoenix Firestar.